to the next video in Healthy Coop Boot Camp. So today we're going to talk about do-it-yourself brooders, how to make one for about $12, and you can make this in probably about 15 minutes. So let's go ahead and I will show you how I did it. So what you want to do is you want to grab a Tupperware bin. This is a smaller one that I made just because it was easier to fit in the screen of the video, but you can easily scale it up or down based on the size that you need. This is an 18-gallon Tupperware bin. I just bought it for about $6 at a Dollar General. What you want to do is you want to make sure you get the top, okay? So what we do with the top is we simply just cut a big hole in it. You can see that. And then this is half-inch hardware cloth that we have attached to the top. And the nice thing about this is once you attach it, the whole thing just snaps together like this. And as your chicks get older, having that top on there is really important because at about 4 weeks or so, they're going to start to try to fly out. And unless you want chicken poop all over your home or wherever you're keeping them, you're going to want a top on the brooder for them, okay? So the way that we actually attached this was that we drilled a series of small holes along it, and then on the back side, we just attached it and just tamped them down, and it holds itself all together. You don't have to do that if you don't want to. If you can find a different way to attach it that works for you, then that's fine. This is the easiest, most efficient way that we found. We just used a very thin drill bit in order to drill all the holes, and we drilled them at the half-inch intervals that the half-inch hardware cloth has. So that's basically how you make your brooder in about 15 minutes and for less than $12. Now, I want to take a minute to talk about safety here. What would a brooder video be without safety? Let me show you this. See this right here? You can see me in there, can't you? That's what happens when you use a heat lamp and, for whatever reason, don't attend to it. So what happened with this, this was actually the brooder that we were using with a piglet a few weeks ago. And I don't know exactly what happened. I can't tell you what happened. But we woke up and the piglet has somehow managed to dislodge the heat lamp. And we don't use hot heat lamps. We don't use the infrared lamps at all. We simply just use light bulbs, regular light bulbs. And there were large shavings in the bottom of this for the piglet. If you don't know, piglets actually require... they can't regulate the body heat when they're born. They actually do acquire heat lamps, just like chicks do. But somehow in the middle of the night, even though the heat lamp had been secure for 3 weeks, somehow in the middle of the night, the piglet managed to dislodge it. And it burned this lovely big hole and actually filled up our whole house with smoke. And the part of the brooder that was there, that used to be there, is actually now attached to our kitchen floor, thanks to it melting onto the floor. So the story here, the moral of the story, is if you want to have a DIY brooder, reconsider using heat lamps. I'm not going to tell you to not use them because in some situations they are necessary. For example, if it's negative 30 degrees in your area and you have chicks in your house and your house is 60 degrees, you're probably going to need a heat lamp. But for us going forward, we're actually not going to breed chicks in the winter. We're going to wait until about this time of year when it's 80 degrees outside and the interior of the house is warm enough. So this is just a lesson, my little PSA on safety for the day.